U.S. energy firms this week cut the number of oil and natural gas rigs operating for a sixth week in a row, energy services firm Baker Hughes said in its closely followed report on Friday. The oil and gas rig count, an early indicator of future output, fell by 12 to 642 in the week of August 18, the lowest since February 2022. U.S. oil rigs fell by 5 to 520 this week, their lowest since March 2022, while gas rigs dropped by 6 to 117, their lowest since February 2022. Oil and natural gas output from top U.S. shale-producing regions is set to fall in September for the second straight month, to the lowest levels since May. Dutch and British wholesale prompt contracts gained on Friday morning due to lower wind power generation, but prices along the curve eased amid uncertainty over the impact of potential strikes at Australian LNG facilities. According to the Refinitiv gas analyst, due to the uncertainty surrounding the upcoming month and season which is affecting day-ahead prices, and the heightened demand for gas in power generation following a decrease in wind speeds, a bullish perspective is adopted. An uptick in Norwegian gas infrastructure maintenance next week will also tighten the supply-demand balance in Britain. Workers at Chevron's Australian Gorgon and Wheatstone LNG facilities have begun voting on potential strike action, with ballots due to close by August 24 and August 28 at the latest. Any disruption lasting more than a month is likely to have a material impact on the supply-demand balance over the northern winter. Still, Australian LNG from affected sites is mainly shipped to Japan and South Korea. Knowing that LNG demand in these two countries is currently relatively weak, posting a year-on-year decline, it is not sure they would be willing to aggressively overbid to get LNG from other sources. The world's largest LNG buyer, China, was also unlikely to buy LNG at any price because it has cheaper alternatives such as coal, gas from domestic production and pipeline imports. Meanwhile, Ukraine does not intend to negotiate with Russia over the extension of the contract on gas transit to Europe, Energy Minister Herman Halashchenko stated on Thursday. The contract, which provides for the transit of gas from Russia to Europe through the territory of Ukraine, ends in 2024. Under the terms of the agreement, during this time Gazprom must pump 225 billion cubic meters of gas through Ukraine, including 65 billion cubic meters in 2020 and 40 billion cubic meters each following year. Galushchenko said that Ukraine will definitely not be a party to the negotiations with the Russians, and the next year will be indicative in terms of Europe's ability to function without Russian gas at all. Moreover, having full storage is no guarantee of winter supply security. While storage typically provides 25%-30% of the gas consumed in the EU during winter, a protracted cold winter could potentially deplete stocks to dangerous levels, particularly in the absence of any Russian gas supply. In these circumstances, Europe will rely solely on the American LNG supply. Moreover, potential labor strikes in Australia could impact the global LNG market, leading to reduced LNG flows. This could result in significantly higher global gas prices during the upcoming heating season. Don't forget to smash the like button and turn on your notifications bell if you enjoyed the video. See you in the next one.